baby, comma, poison shootings. We got the full rundown coming up of this week's episodes of Days of Our Lives with special guests Sal Stowers and Lamon Archey. Coming up next.
You're tuning into the destination for TV superfan discussion, AfterBuzz TV. And now, let the buzz begin.
Well, hello and good afternoon, all of you Days of Our Lives fans. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV's Dishin Days, where we give you a full recap of NBC's hit number one soap opera, Days of Our Lives. I'm your host, Tony Moore, and I am joined by a gaggle of gals and one dude. We have...
It's you, by the way.
We have to my far, 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 far left, my favorite... somebody.
Favorite baby poison, Mark J. Freeman.
Baby, comma, poison. And we also have our newest co-host.
Hey, y'all. It's Tami Goveia. How are you? Missed you.
And, of course, we have another new co-host. It sounds like Survivor up in
I
here.
Know.
We also have joining us today.
Oh, me. That's me. Michael Mattis. Hello.
And, of course, we have two familiar faces. You guys know them as Lani and Eli. Give it up for Lamon Archey and Sal Stowers in the house. Finally, we got Sal in the house.
Oh, that's what I was going to do.
It's been like a long time coming.
I'm going to go look back and see when it was that I messaged her the first time.
I think it was like in 2015.
Yeah,
like,
easily.
Like October...
Oh no, was it that long ago?
Yeah.
I'm gonna.
Okay,
it was a while ago.
Well, we've been trying.
I don't think hard enough.
I know.
Okay. I'm here now, though. I'm here.
We did everything except, like, run up to the studio and Norm Array it with just, like, a sign with your name on it.
Next time, I'm gonna need you to do that. just really show me how much you love me and you want me here.
We love you, Sal. We love you. And, of course, welcome back, Lamon.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate
Moan,
it.
Moan. And if you guys are watching live, thank you for always tuning in. And if you haven't followed us on the social media platform, we are Dishin Days on Instagram and Facebook and _ Dishin Days on Twitter. The @ is implied. All right, so we have so much to cover that we're just going to get right into it. It's now time to start
Dishin Days.
Oh, cool.
Right. Yeah. And we set it and forget
it.
All right, so let's kick things off with... this Steve, John, Will, Paul storyline. Mm-hmm. Well, first of all, I just want to start off that, like, if you're going to be, like, a spy and, like, follow somebody, you better Nancy Drew it all the way through. Like, you better go to the hospital and get scrubs and, like, all that kind of stuff.
They were literally just standing, like, in plain sight.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
Everywhere they went.
The ending of that was funny.
Yeah, it's like...
They're both like...
It's like, they were literally just standing in the hallway, and Marlena's like,
hey,
Will, Paul, what are you doing here? And they're like, oh.
We're here to see our friend in administration.
Didn't they say Derek?
They're like,
yeah, they said Derek. Yeah. But I'm like, administration? What floor is that on? Like, did you just...
They were just pressing buttons.
Yeah, they were just like, oh, I'm sorry, I need to go into this floor. Now I'm just going to, yeah. But
very suspicious.
Yeah, but...
Sneaky.
But then I got all nervous because they were following them, and then Paul went after... First, they need to give that guy a name.
I mean, you know what? Oh, I don't
I keep calling
so bad,
him the drug guy.
I can never remember the drug his name.
Yeah.
I call him Agent Guy.
The Agent Guy?
He's an ISA muckety muck.
Okay.
That's an official title.
Because he said that. He said, our muckety muck's at the ISA.
Oh.
So we'll just call him from now, call him muckety muck. Yeah, Eminem. There you go.
Okay. We'll see if that catches on.
Hashtag.
Paul went after him, and then Will went after John. Ooh, Will...
September 12th, 2015.
You were determined to find that.
That was close.
You were determined to find that.
I was on a mission.
Even beat me on.
I'm glad it's on you guys.
I know, right?
I know, right?
I'm gonna bow out too. I'm gonna say it's on Mark.
I'll take it.
I never got an email after that.
It was all Mark.
Ghosted.
Will. Let's see, how can I say this? Will turn real like white woman by like just like spewing out everything. Like, I know what you did. I saw it. See, you can't do that. You have to like play it cool. You have to be like.
He has amnesia. I'm sure it's affected his common sense.
That's
the rationalization I was trying to come up with.
Yeah, but I wasn't expecting John to like pull out the gun and like
no,
take him to the Demera.
It escalated very quickly.
It went wrong.
From like zero to ten, like that.
I just have a feeling Monday it's going to go just as quickly in a different direction. You know what I mean? Like, it's the setup because we got to give him something to talk about all weekend, and then we come back and John's be like, girl, I was just playing. I was at Brent's.
Yeah.
It's all part of the thing, blah, blah, blah. So that's my prediction for next week.
I hope so, because poor Will, like, you can't kill him off again. You just brought him back to life.
Well, yeah.
And John's not going to do that.
Like Ben, huh?
He's not going to do that. He's not going to kill Will and Paul. So, you know, it's either pretend you're dead because of the
right. That's what I was thinking. Like, he's telling them because he couldn't hear.
Right.
That's why he went into the mausoleum.
Right. That's why he took him to the mausoleum because no one could hear.
Yeah.
Right. Because remember when he destroyed the vial and Eminem was watching and they got all upset with him?
Yeah.
So now he took him somewhere private so he could.
So if he was being followed.
Right. Yeah.
The dramatization of it all. Now, I don't know how familiar y'all are with the storyline, but just listening to all this craziness.
You're like, I'm glad I ain't part of that.
It's like,
I got enough to worry about.
It's like, sounds like. Wait a minute, I'm trying to figure out how to pass this baby off as Jason.
I don't have no time to think about anybody else's story alive. I got to deal with this baby right now. Okay, I got my own little stuff going on.
And I can't wait till we come up and talk about that.
I know, there's so much.
But really, that's pretty much all that happened with that storyline this week. Am I missing anything?
Well, do you want to talk about Steve?
Oh, or is that
go ahead.
Yeah.
Well, the fact that he's like, go ahead.
Okay, so the only rationalization that I can come up with that John would even be going down this road is...
Of trying to kill him, mind you.
Okay, so it's not even putting him out of commission, it's killing him.
Okay. Yeah.
So that was the big, like, what?
Yeah.
What if Steve isn't really Steve?
Hmm.
And they need to get rid of him?
We need no more doppelgangers.
Huh. Doppelganger.
I can't think of anything else. What did I say?
Doppler.
I mean, that's a very Days of Our Lives thing to do.
Someone is not someone. Yeah.
You think so?
Like
John's
not
John,
or
Steve's
Steve
isn't
Steve.
Or
I will say this. Mark is Mark.
Always.
Or is he Lorraine?
You'll know. Trust.
I don't know. Well, maybe like the added piece to the puzzle will come next week because, you know, Lisa Rinna is back as Billy.
Yeah.
So like I feel like, because I was watching Real Housewives of Beverly Hills because, you know, that's my thing. And she said on there that she comes back as like an FBI agent. And
she
I'm like,
gun.
Oh, but that was my first thought. And then I was like, did you clear this with NBC before you, like...
announced it?
Announced, like, you know, that you're coming back as an FBI agent?
Well, she would have
Well, she always yeah. was yeah. part of that world.
Was
she? Yeah. I mean, she was she worked for the PD, which we know her still.
Right. PD.
Telling everybody...
Sorry, girl.
Salem PD.
Sorry.
You got one of them right here.
Two.
Two. That's right. I'm sorry. I don't know. Everyone keeps counting you out.
I was saying her, and then I was like, oh, wait, no, he is too.
Well, no. Right. All this week, everyone's like, don't give her too much. You know she's pregnant. I'm like, geez, like, the poor girl's only a month. I know girls who were, like, doing their job till they were, like, 9 months pregnant. They're like, I'm having the baby tomorrow.
I had a girl that was pregnant bartending next to me, like, at 8 months. Like, she got, I gotta go pump my breast milk. I'm like, okay, girl, you do what you need to do.
You go do you.
You do you.
Just don't drop in the drinks.
Breast milk before the baby's born?
Yeah.
What?
Or was no? It was after. Right after.
Yeah,
it was right
you have
after.
To.
Right
you can't. Yeah. After. I mean,
yeah. You was about to teach me something.
I don't have kids, so I don't know, but I'm pretty sure it's after.
It's after. Yeah, it was after.
So Steve. So yeah.
So maybe that's not really Steve. I don't know.
Or he's faking.
Who?
Or Steve. John's told him what he's doing, and he's pretending.
Yeah, he's faking it. Yeah.
To be dizzy, he's pretending
How
to not be.
Could he fake not breathing though?
Oh, going into cardiac arrest.
I mean, it's Days. There's a way.
Mean, yeah. Anything.
He took some secret special training in Asia, and he knows how to stop himself from breathing.
Maybe.
He knows how to simulate.
He was friends with John, Mr. Robich.
Oh, God.
Wait, what?
John Black's dad.
Robichaud.
The real Robichaud.
We had this whole show where we were like, what if it wasn't like Marlena Black, it was Marlena Robichaud?
Because that was technically his real awful. Name.
Yeah. See, yeah, we went there. Yeah. Okay, well, that's it with that storyline. We'll see what happens with that. Like, hopefully no one has died and again. And
well, and this, I was going to say this too. This kind of just ties into it real quick, is that there was a scene at the end of this week with Justin and Sonny, mm-hmm. where Justin makes a comment that maybe something traumatic will happen to Will to help him remember.
Yeah. He said it a few times.
Yeah. So that was only thing I think is interesting is that maybe that's why this is happening, mm-hmm. to kind of so we
to trigger can Will's get his memory.
Yeah.
But I don't want Will to remember. Okay, I like Will's
memory back and pull a Sammy and not tell anyone. That's what I think is going to happen. When Will gets his memory back, he's going to hide it.
He won't tell anyone? Well,
my prediction.
I mean, I like this, like, free spirit Will. Mm-hmm. I don't want to call him whole Will, but, like...
See, I want to see a little bit of whole Will.
But, like, just free spirit.
Whole
Will.
Yeah. Or whole.
Whole.
Whole Will.
Whole.
Yeah, I'm not touching
him. He began popping already.
Well, he was like, listen, like, I know that, like, we were married and everything, but I feel like I need to, like, you know, explore now that I'm, like, you know, coming in tune myself. And I was like, attaboy.
Explore.
You go do you. There's not many gay people in Salem, but if you find them, you let us know. There are three, and all of y'all are in the town with each other.
They got a shuttle to Chicago, girl.
All right, well, speaking of murders and shootings and things.
Oh, my.
Right. So now we have the suspects in Andre's murder. First, I like the fact that they brought Hattie back. Mm-hmm. Love when Deidre Hall plays Hattie.
Yeah.
It's so much fun because you can tell the, like, distinctive, like, changes that she makes,
mm-hmm.
and, like, the little clues that she has in order to become Hattie. Mm-hmm. And I'm just like, man, like, I really wish that Hattie could be around. Apparently she can, because you can sneak in and out of jail.
Right. Just,
no big deal. Yeah.
Just, you know,
really anyone knowing.
Like, I like that she was like, so listen, Hope, like, you know, this never happened. I'm just gonna sneak back in the way that I sneaked out. And it's like, we're cool, right? And Hope's like, nah, girl.
No.
We gonna take you someplace where, like, you're really secured. I'm like, no, don't do that to Hattie. We want her to, like, come back out every now and then.
Yeah.
Like, have a drink at the Brady Pub and then go back and tell the girls how it was.
Yeah.
It needs to be something like that. I like that.
I'd be down with that.
But this, so Hattie wrote the note. We found that out.
Which I still don't really understand the rationale behind it, because it doesn't really have anything to do with Anna and Roman other than just getting her riled up. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it just didn't really seem...
So when
I'll play along,
right?
Because that's what I do, but I don't really buy it 100%. I mean, I know it's what happened, but it just didn't really fit.
Doesn't make sense.
Sometimes it comes back together and you're just like, that doesn't really fit, but I'll let it go.
Well, it was her trying to be like, okay, so I see you on Instagram. By the way, in case you didn't know, Brady Pub has an Instagram.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's how she knew. Yeah. She was watching the Brady Pub.
Patty was like, I was in jail scrolling through Instagram and saw a picture of y'all two, and I was like, no, like, this blonde bimbo can't be with my man, so I snuck out of jail, wrote this note to get you riled up.
Because she has a job in jail in the administration office. Right.
Yeah.
Right. So
yeah.
She had access.
She works for the warden.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
Jail must be life.
Nice.
Right? Yeah.
It must be nice over
there. We can arrange it for you, Tami.
No. I tell everyone I'm too cute to go to jail. I'm gonna.
We'll send you to a women's prison, girl.
I can relate more.
I don't think you can.
But
I'm getting an app workout over here.
So it's like, so I think I kind of get it. Like, she was trying to get Anna away from Roman, mm-hmm. but, you know, she went about it in the Hattie sort of a way. Mm-hmm. But then we find out that Anna actually did go to Andre's office, mm-hmm. and was going to kill him, but then.
Was that she went there with the intent? I don't think she went there with the intent.
Not with the intent, but she got provoked and she raised up the martini shaker with the ashes in it. And then Andre turned around and snatched the ashes, which I was like, you don't snatch that girl's ashes. Right. Like,
no, that was cruel.
And then
like that scene, I was like, all right,
I was like, oh no. And the way he slammed it down, like, boom, I was like, oh, you are just dirty. That is just all wrong. But obviously, she didn't do it. And then Gabby is like, again, the main suspect, because even though we saw her leave, they now suspect that she came back.
Yeah. And you just didn't see her face.
With this bad wig.
With the bad wig, yeah.
Oh, that wig.
It does not look like her.
There's a drag queen in Salem.
It doesn't look like her.
I knew you scammed your way onto Salem. I knew it. I knew it.
I wish I was that thin.
Well, the coat looked very flowy, so I don't know.
Maybe. Maybe. Love.
You're vegan now, so you might be slimming down more than you know.
Are you vegan? Me too.
Like a month and a half.
That's why I can't eat these pizzas.
That was my idea. Now I can't partake in them anymore. I know.
It's all right. Leave it to the fat kids. All right. So Gabby's now the main suspect, and like, you know, they found that little clip and the little piece of the...
Okay.
Are you confused about that too?
Let's talk about
the
megapixel image that Rafe was able to see that was the lid to the urn.
Well, Eli pulled it up.
But that was like all these like mega...
You couldn't tell.
I got up from my couch. I walked up to TV. I said, no, girl, I don't see that.
Did you put your glasses on?
This is a 55-inch TV. I can't see that. No, that isn't... I don't know. I mean, again, I'm going to go with it.
Okay, well, I'll say this. Neither
you were in the room. Tell us what really. Yeah, okay,
Neither Galen nor I actually saw what they put up on the screen.
Right.
Oh, really?
So it was on the TV.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We were just looking at a flat
glass.
Sorry
that.
To ruin that for those of you at home.
So I'm sitting here putting the clue. I feel like I'm Salem PD right now trying to put the clues together just by you guys telling us what's going on.
Right. Right.
But yeah, no, I mean, I feel the same way. When I was looking, I was like, oh, that's a bad wig.
See?
Yeah.
Like her.
Yeah. I feel like, and I don't want to say this because, like, I feel like I may be giving something away, but I think there's clues that were in previous episodes that could allude to what we just saw this week.
Mm. Okay.
Huh?
Yes. Yeah.
Sure. Well, I think that's normal.
Yeah. No, but if you really think about it, there was a conversation that happened, and there were certain
things. So you don't want to share that?
Well, no, because I get nervous on this show, like when I say something and like something happens, and you know people are eyeing me and being like, "How'd you know that? You're so close to the show."
Okay,
I'm just smart.
Well, who do you guys think is the actual murderer?
Someone on Twitter reading.
On Twitter is?
Someone on Twitter.
Tami got real nervous.
No, someone on Twitter had a theory that after watching the show, I'm like, oh, it makes sense. It's Abigail, and she has like a split
personality. My gosh.
Where was she at during the murder?
We don't know.
We don't know where a lot of people are.
She's the one that she found the body.
Yeah, she found Andre.
And so there's a theory that it's Abigail and Abigail's alternative personality or split personality.
I don't know why that
frame,
makes sense.
Frame
are
Gabby.
They going to make her cuckoo
because,
for Cocoa Puffs?
She is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Wow.
It's just nobody knows it yet.
And that's why Stefan blacked out that time frame, because maybe she's on... the
maybe
camera.
He knows.
Maybe
yeah.
she's on the foot in the footage, and he's protecting her.
But then, why are Stefan and Vivian trying to act like they did it? Like, I feel like case closed. Like,
I feel like when they talk about what they did, it wasn't the murder. It's something else,
right?
That's something that maybe, and I don't know. Maybe something we don't know or something.
I think it's just taking over the company.
Right. They're just talking about
now
in general
Andre's
what they're
gone,
doing with the company,
perfect.
Not like Andre's murder.
Yeah.
When they're talking about their deeds or. Whatever.
I think it was John Black.
He's done everything. He killed Andre.
It seems like everyone in Salem is guilty.
Yeah.
I mean, they've made a case for almost everybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kudos to Days for keeping us guessing.
Now I just wonder who it is.
Dun, dun, dun.
I mean, we'll find
dun,
out eventually.
It's Lonnie's baby.
Oh, baby. Darn it.
Okay, well, speaking of a baby.
Perfect segue into our next part.
Yes. Let's get into
baby poison.
Baby comma poison.
Baby comma poison. Sorry.
So.
That's funny.
This week, we finally
eyes
have.
On you.
I think her cheeks hurt.
They do.
So we have the Eli, Lonnie, JJ storyline. And
Can I just start with saying that you and Vanessa
That was my favorite scene this week, by the way.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you talking about Shave Fest 2018 in the pub?
Yeah.
The work that the two of you are doing, I'm getting like chills, has been powerful. Mm-hmm. Powerful.
Thank you.
And just your growth from the time that you started the show and then you left and came back on again, it's amazing. And, you know, and the fans are tweeting about it, and it's just, it's appreciated. It's being noticed. It's being... Mm-hmm. Really, really phenomenal work.
You got got some good stuff going on.
I really do appreciate that. Thank you.
From Halo to babies.
It's a natural progression.
So, finally, this week, Eli knows that he the baby daddy.
Mm-hmm. And the fact, and how you did it totally shocked me. He's like, look, I don't have the time. I don't have the time for this. And you're like, you know, like, what? Listen, there's never going
to
be
her. You're not to hear me. Yeah.
She was like,
I only got 20 hours left.
But I think she also had the pressure from Valerie. Yeah. You know? So it's like she has to do it. You know, and I think it's,
it was almost like, I felt like panic. It was interesting because I felt like Valerie was almost softening towards her. And then she gets up and is like, you have 24 hours. I was like, oh, no, she means business.
No, she's not playing. You're not going to lie to my son.
Yeah. She went to the Kate Roberts School of Mothering.
Yeah, she did.
Meddling in the lives, but you know,
like that was her being nice by giving you the 24 hours because I felt like,
and not just blabbing it straight away. Yeah,
she was gonna be like, listen, that's my son, and I put two and two together.
I mean, she went through my files.
She sure did.
I know
that is just, you do not do that.
Yeah.
You know?
HIPAA.
No.
HIPAA.
She was determined. If this one wouldn't have told her we slept together, then she wouldn't have known.
Right.
But she,
that's my mama.
Right.
But what do? You tell your mom, everybody you sleep with. Mom.
In Salem,
yes, right.
In Salem, you have to say, but I feel like Valerie like picked up on stuff like since.
Oh yeah, she knew since then.
She was like, something's going on, and you felt like, I can't hide this from her. Like I just have to tell her.
Yeah,
and then
inside.
She turned into Nancy Drew and was like, "You pregnant?" And then she was like, "Wait a minute."
Mama's in time frame. Like how far along is she?
Yeah.
Oh, but. Shave Fest 2018 when they were sitting at the pub, she's like, "Oh, so when did you do?"
Oh, I know.
Well,
I think I even tweeted out when she was just like, when she was talking about like the signs, and she's like, girl, Virgo. Hey, it's a Virgo. I was like, you go, girl.
So like playing this storyline and like and getting it and seeing the scripts and everything and how it's starting to unfold up until this week, like how has it been for you, Sal, and for you, Lamon? We'll start with Sal first.
I mean, for myself, I remember getting that script of where, you know, Lani gets dizzy and I'm like, oh shit, excuse my language.
Oh, no,
is she about to be pregnant? You know, and I'm like, oh, I don't think they're going to do that. And then sure enough, the next one, I'm like, holy crap. And then I sat with it for a little bit because I had no idea if it was going to be JJ's or Eli's.
Mm-hmm.
So finally, finding out that it was his, I was like, oh, okay, they're going, somewhere with this. But it's been really fun.
Yeah.
It's been really fun to play, and it's been challenging at the same time.
Yeah.
You know, because I've had to kind of go into this place with Lani where, you know, obviously she's lying, and she wants to be with JJ, and she's going to do anything and everything to keep this secret in. As you guys saw, she was trying to get this man to,
which shocked me.
Please do not tell anyone.
It's like don't say nothing.
Yes. But that's just, in her mind, she's like, it can all be right. I have to, you know, I have to protect JJ. And she doesn't want to be responsible for him spiraling down.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
So she doesn't want to lose him, you know? And I think that's just in her mindset. She's like, everything that she's doing, this is right. This has to go this way, you know?
Yeah.
It's a fun story. I love it.
I give you kudos for this scene a couple of weeks ago when you revealed that you were going to pass the baby off as JJ's. And I think at that moment...
With Kayla?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Everyone was like, but how are you going to do that? Because JJ White...
Did you see someone post... Did you see that? I think I tagged you in it where they put your head on the baby.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I laughed so hard. But even when I read that, because, you know, Kayla says that, and I'm like, well, I'm light-skinned, and Eli's dad is white, and I'm just like, what?
Yeah.
Am I really good at...
Black and white.
Wait.
Yeah.
Huh?
You said Eli's. Eli's dad. Yeah. Oh, I didn't say Dave, Eli.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
no.
Okay, yeah,
no,
yeah,
your yeah, father. Yeah, yeah, yeah. White. Is white, and I'm just like, oh my god, am I really gonna say this?
Yeah,
because I had to, you know, me hearing that, I'm like, I sound batshit crazy. You know? But then for Lani, it's like I said, she truly believes.
In Lani's
that
mind, it's all rational.
It's all yeah. rational. Exactly. Yeah. She what she's doing. She doesn't see wrong in no. at it at all.
She commits to it.
Right. Yeah. She's protecting everyone involved, mm-hmm. and she's gonna own up to this, yeah. you know? Doesn't matter how crazy she
well,
looks.
Well, I'll tell you, when you explained it, I was like, okay, well, sounds right to me. I mean, kudos to you, girl.
And Mary Beth. Work.
You're doing great on that one.
I love working with Mary Beth, but I just remember her staring at me like... All right, yep. you know.
Trust me, everyone that was watching yeah. it was like,
okay,
okay, all right, that makes sense. We like pulled out diagrams. Was like, okay, so Eli and Valerie and then yeah. you and then okay equals light skinned baby. Got it. Okay,
light skinned baby. He's not gonna, you know, yeah. he's yeah. not gonna look black at all. It's just right. looks, gonna look like JJ's baby.
Yeah,
this is what it's gonna be. Just yeah. accept it, everyone.
Yeah,
listen, I bought it. Because at first I was like, now, Lani, now you know you can't pass that baby. And then you explained it, and I was like, I'm sold. Okay, sounds good to me.
Honest, there's so many, even in my family, there mm-hmm. are so many, there's so many biracial people out there right. who mm-hmm. they can be all black. And you're like, yeah. what? Mm-hmm. You're what?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, so you just sure. never know.
Never know. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And with this whole Ancestry.com stuff,
yeah.
you just discover a whole bunch of stuff.
Exactly.
So
yep.
it's possible.
I found
it's
out I'm 10% Great Britain. I'm going to the wedding. In
Days 2024. Lonnie's baby does 23andMe and finds out.
There you go.
Sponsored by 23andMe.
Sponsored by 23andMe and Totino's Pizza Rolls.
Right. Lamon, how was it for you, like, finding out that being a part of this storyline and being the baby daddy and all that?
I think it happened pretty fast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It happened like, pretty fast. I remember,
boom.
Well, what, we got the script, you know, we had the love scene, and then maybe, like, a week and a half or so later,
yeah,
we got another script, and we're like,
you
pregnant?
it did happen really fast, and it caught us both off guard, because we're like, wait.
Yeah.
What? Oh, okay. Huh. Yeah. You know, because I've been working with Casey for so long, that yeah. I don't know.
Yeah, no, it happened fast. but it's just, it's a fun story to be involved in.
Yeah.
You know, there's so many different things that Eli is going through right now. I mean, he's got the murder case with Andre and trying mm-hmm. to find that, trying to protect Gabby and, mm-hmm. you know, being involved in that. And also he's got, you know, worried about
Lani.
I almost said Sal. Yeah. I'm trying to connect
oh,
those two.
We
I just
do it all
malfunction.
The time. We do it all the time.
Yeah. But, you know, he's just got so many things that's going on in his life right now mm-hmm. that I appreciated it, and I was happy to get that material.
Yeah.
Yeah.
yeah. yeah. And, of course, you guys are, like, doing such a great job
Thank
with
you.
It. The first thing I thought when Lani was pregnant, I was like, I wonder what Sal is going to do to, like, get into this whole, like, pregnant mind frame. Because I remember when you had the Halo storyline, you told us that, like, you, like, locked yourself in a room mm-hmm. in the dark.
Did drugs.
And, like, tried
yeah.
to, like,
drugs.
And tried to, like, feel that.
The method way.
And I was just like, I
Or
wonder.
We not supposed to tell
well,
people that?
This was actually harder because yeah. being a woman, you know, I've never been pregnant, so yeah. I don't know what that, yeah. what
right.
that feels
right.
like. I don't yeah. know that connection. I don't mm-hmm. I don't know. And, mm-hmm. you know, so there, I for a while, it was not there. I was like, oh, God, I'm going to suck because I couldn't find it,
Connect
you know, but
something.
Then I started going to the place of like, well, wait a minute. Lani really doesn't, because she knows the truth. Mm-hmm. You know, she knows that Eli is the father.
Yeah.
So there's a part of her that she doesn't really, there's not really that connection with the baby because it's not with the man that she wants mm-hmm. it to be,
yeah.
you know? So
yeah.
I kind of went that route and yeah. that actually helped me,
right.
you know, have more of a connection
yeah.
with the pregnancy,
yeah.
you know, instead of just trying to be, oh my God, I'm pregnant. No, because she was not happy when she found out she was
Way
pregnant.
Way too many other
yeah.
things
right.
in
she
mind.
She was
so,
miserable,
yeah.
you
yeah.
know, and so she looks at it as a mistake.
Mm-hmm.
And so I kind of went that way.
Mm-hmm.
But I think as a woman, it does kind of get in your head a little bit, you know, playing pregnant because you're like, oh, well, how is this going to feel?
Right.
Yeah.
And then poor JJ just walking around Salem, just buying everything.
Oh, my gosh.
There was one scene where I was like, when is she just going to go off on him and tell him to shut up? And she finally
Well, I did, a little bit.
I was like, you know, your prenatal vitamins, and if you take a double dose, if you miss one. And I was just like, shut up.
Because you know he has something to live for now. Yeah. Right. He's so excited. You know, and it's just, I think that, and he's pushing it in Lonnie's face, and she's like, you know, it's hitting her. You know, what she's doing is it's not right.
Yeah.
The scene where he was holding two bikes.
I laughed out loud.
That got
what a
me.
Sucker.
But when we filmed that, when he walked in, I literally, I mean, come on, it was the cutest thing I've ever seen. Yeah. He has a blue and a pink one, and I was like, oh, God. He's like, it's twins. Is it boy or girl? I'm like, oh, my God, this is so cute. Fuck, Lonnie.
Yeah. Am I the only one that had the thought of, well, you gonna have to take one of them back, and I hope you got it from Target, because in like 9 months, like, you're not gonna be able to take one of them back.
Yeah.
You
know,
like, was
you're
I
the only one that had that thought.
I was the only one that had that thought. I was like, how you gonna take one back though?
He can get one to Gabby if she get pregnant, since Eli just, you know, he's super sperm.
He's fertile.
Yeah, you Eli, fertile.
He is fertile. All you over fertile.
Listen.
One time.
Yeah.
It was the whiskey, you guys.
That's right. That's right.
Jazz and liquor will make you do some things. That's what it is. And then JJ went to Abe and asked for Lonnie's hand in marriage.
So sweet.
And
I didn't expect it either.
But then I suddenly felt like Valerie, where I was like, "Ooh, girl, no, you don't want to do that." But I like that she also played that role. Like, maybe you should just kind of think about
it.
You don't
have to be married.
Don't have to rush into it.
And because I think all of us were like, JJ, not yet. Because no, don't do it. No, not right now.
Vanessa's so good with the side eye.
Yeah,
the shade.
Totally.
She's subtle.
Oh
my gosh.
Listen,
so I loved every moment of her stealing that file. And like, those were my favorite episodes those days. I was tweeting her. I was like, surgeon by day, detective by night. I was like, loving every minute of it. Yeah, I was like, this is why I tune in for this kind of stuff. And,
that was good. But I think that's pretty much it. What's going on? I'm anxious.
We
to
still
see.
Don't know though what Eli has what decided Eli if he's going to.
I have my own thoughts on that.
What do you think?
And that's what I've been seeing on Twitter, is he better step up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He better claim it.
He definitely should.
Yeah.
He didn't know his dad. So I think if he was to go the route that Lonnie wants him to go, I think that would be a huge mistake, you know, and not only a mistake, I mean, but it's like he went through
experience.
That.
Yeah.
Why would he?
Yep. I don't think it would be in character for him to go with it.
Yeah.
I don't think it would be in character for him to go with it. Like, as the character, I don't think
that would be. Then why is he even doubting it?
Because I think, what Lonnie says is, she's like, you know, what do you think, you know, Gabby is going to do when she finds out that you not only slept with someone else, but you got her pregnant? What do you think she's going to do? Mm-hmm. You know, so I think that has him like, okay, I don't want to lose this woman, you know, and then neither one of us, you know, they didn't plan to get pregnant. They didn't want to have a baby together, you know, so I think that's
one night of fun.
It was just, just a little night, you know, and I think that also is in his mind too, you know, like,
fear.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fear.
Yeah.
But baby and lose my woman.
Lonnie pleaded a real good case. Like, listen, we can lose everything.
She's desperate.
And like, JJ is going to go down this downward spiral. It was just a lot.
Well,
and I was like,
and I do think one of the arguments that was the strongest was when she told, was it Eli or
Vanessa
that when you saw him that he was going to commit suicide.
Yeah.
When you told somebody that, you were just like, well, look, he was going to do this once. Who's to say he's? And I was like, ooh, girl, she is.
I told them both that, I think. I think I told you that too.
Yeah.
I remember
hearing it, but I can't remember who you were talking to. But it was, I was like, okay, we're going there.
Yeah.
Which is important.
Yeah. She's using this pregnancy to keep JJ afloat.
I think each character has strong beliefs in why they should do the things that they're doing, and whatever those things are, they truthfully believe that it is the best for
the right
everyone around.
Yeah.
I don't think anyone can tell them otherwise.
Yeah.
I think they are dead set in what in what their beliefs are.
Because you kind of see it from everyone's point of view. You understand why Valerie got into it because, like, she didn't want history to repeat itself with your baby. And then the dilemma that Lonnie is in by wanting to pass this off as JJ's because of the state that JJ is in, but also looking out for Eli because she doesn't want you to lose everything. So it's like, it's
and
like
herself
this whole,
too. She doesn't want to lose JJ.
Yeah.
You know,
it's like this whole like, ooh, it's like, just give the baby up for adoption. Like, you know, just send it. And then, like, you know, it'll find its way back to Salem eventually.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
And then it'll all be, I was like, oh, you, oh, okay, how that, okay.
The writers really tied all the stories together and blended them.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah. It was really, ooh, I'm on pins and needles about, ooh, but when that baby comes. Oh,
a big cute baby though.
Yeah, definitely.
From me.
Oh my god, that's exactly what my mom says. My mom is like, you know, you got everything from me, right?
That's always the woman.
And I'm like, my dad contributed nothing. Well, there's that.
He did
contribute something.
Yeah. Probably the most important thing. All right, so those are the top three storylines, and then let's quickly get into tidbits, and then our segments, and then we're gonna open the phone lines up for you guys to call in with your questions.
There's a lot in the chat room. Some of them I don't think they're going to be able to answer, guys, so just be aware of that.
Mm-hmm. You know, we can only talk about stuff that just recently happened. Don't be getting us in trouble.
Right.
So the first one is this Trip Claire Sierra storyline.
It's cute.
It's cute, yeah.
It's there.
Yeah.
They're slowly doing something with it.
Yeah.
Whatever that is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The younger generation actors are really good, I must say that.
Yeah.
They are good.
They're really good.
Who?
Just the younger generation.
Yeah.
Olivia, really
I think they're all doing Victoria. A great job. And especially Victoria, like coming in as I like to call her badass Sierra though.
Just I
feel like they established that when she rolled in on the motorcycle and like she had the helmet and she like tossed the hair.
You just never had those kind of moments with the other Sierra. And I don't know if that was just the writing, or you know, the Ron was just like, "No, we're gonna. We need to really take her down this way. This needs to be
with the previous Sierra, Vivian. I think her name was. I think they were making Sierra. Okay, that Sierra is Hope's daughter. Now Victoria is now Beau's daughter.
Well, but they always implied not that they're two different people or two different characters, but it's the same character. But they did always say that Vivian, when it was Vivian, that it was Beau's. That's why she was the tough girl and all that. So there was always that. I mean, I know what you're saying.
Yeah.
But no, they were saying that it should have been Beau's, and it wasn't coming off that way. I definitely think
Victoria is
getting that across a little better.
So do we think they're going to do a Trip Sierra pairing? That's where this is going, right?
It sounds like seems like that way.
I hope so.
Seems that way.
They're cute together. I like it.
But then for some reason, I feel like...
Well, there has to be something for when Theo comes back. Something's got to be going on.
But I feel like Claire is like getting jealous of the attention that Trip is giving to Sierra.
Claire wants it all.
Yeah,
I'm like, well, girl, your man is in South Africa.
South Africa.
Mm-hmm. I'm like, you can go there.
Yep. That's all teenage girls, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
We all, you know, you always want the attention.
Yeah, exactly.
I
mean,
listen, if I was Claire, I would have already booked my ticket.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Just saying.
I like the chemistry between the three of them.
Yeah.
The chemistry is really good, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, I think it's great chemistry. Yeah. And then we have Brady and Eve.
On their
date.
They
look so pretty.
I liked them this week.
Oh my god.
I liked them being nice to each other. Like they were actually cute this week.
I don't know if Tony does.
What?
How you gonna get dressed up to go to Horton Town Square?
Oh, I know, I thought the same thing.
There was one moment.
It's Salem.
In the same episode.
Y'all could have dressed up in Salem.
Yeah.
But y'all could have went to Doug's place.
Right. It's like you're sitting outside on a patio.
Well, it's an outdoor space.
Like, dressed for the night.
It's like we're just going to the Grove or like the American.
Yeah, exactly. You
know? But why wasn't it cold? Because someone, I think Eli made a comment about how it's cold in Salem right now. Maybe it was Rafe. It was either Rafe or...
No, I think it was...
And then in the next scene, Brady and Eve are sitting outside with no coats on.
But she put a fur on to leave.
Right.
He put it on her.
Well, it's February in Salem right now.
There was a heat lamp.
Right.
It was the heat between them.
And they're drinking whiskey, so they're good.
But the whole time I felt like Eve was just kind of like, yeah, I feel like we're doing this, but like, you know, we can't talk about that one thing that like we really do enjoy and like, but we and can't do, well. Do anymore and do well at.
And yeah, I'm
like,
we know you do well at it. Like, you've mentioned it a few times.
I'm like, just let it be that. Just let it be
but a who's writing this script?
Mark J. Freeman.
Mark J. Freeman. But I will say, I loved that they're talking about the face, the new face of Bella. Like, I was like,
oh, that's
Touché
very
days. Yeah, that's very I love nostalgic. When they, you know, we love the fans. We love when they bring stuff back.
Yeah.
I love that.
I like
I
it.
I love that.
I liked it too.
And yes, Claire, I think you have a little upper hand since Pop Pop runs the company.
Pop Pop. Who and calls Victor Pop Pop?
She's always called him
Pop Pop. She's always called him Pop Pop. Mm-hmm.
Well, that was the first time I heard
it. Oh, trust me. You should have been here like, the day that I heard it the first time.
It's always been Pop Pop.
Okay. It has been Pop Pop for quite some time.
I think it's cute. I like when they establish the relationships that everyone has, where they say, like, my grandmother, my mother, my brother, my cousin.
The heritage. Whatever.
There was somebody the other day that called somebody by their first name. I think it was, actually, I think it was, it's, no, he keeps doing it. Will keeps saying Marlena.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, girl, could you, if I walked in and called my grandmother Helen, she would have hit me.
But Will doesn't have an amnesia. He doesn't have one. But he does every once in a while call her grandma. I think he's still warm. It's like you going back and forth, like grandmother, Marlena.
I don't care.
I mean, I know
I don't like it.
I couldn't fix my mouth up to say Mildred. As soon as my mom would hear that, she'd be like, "Excuse you."
Yeah. I did it once, and I would never do it again.
No, I don't think I've ever done it. I've been too afraid to. If I say "damn" in front of my mom, I get a little.
I usually will say it and go, I'll go, damn it. Sorry, Ma. But I had to say that. That's usually how it goes. She knows. She's used to me now.
And then last, we have Justin and Sonny.
Well, I said that earlier.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying about.
Oh, that's it? You said it? Yeah. Okay, good. Well, then we're done.
No. Can I just, do we have time for one more thing?
Yeah.
So, Vivian and Stefan.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Stefan O.
The slap.
Stefan O. Oh, yeah, the slap.
Okay. So, listen to this. This is January 21st. From at Wheeling Bird, Annie Goen says, "I keep getting Stefano and Marlena vibes when I see Stefan and Abby. You know the way Stefano is obsessed with Marlena. Almost how Stefan is obsessed with Abby. Almost he hasn't locked her in a cage yet.
Yet,
cage is coming.
And yet. She brought that up this week." Yeah. About being obsessive with Abby.
Well, it was more like being obsessive about things that you can't have.
Right. Mm-hmm. But that obsession mm-hmm. grows. It starts with that. And I thought that would be
amazing.
And if
he is actually Stefano's son, then it's in like his, you know.
Then that little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs is in him.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Days better go into the vault and bring out that gold cage because somebody's about to get locked up in it.
We know how you feel about the cage. Mm-hmm. We know how you feel
it's
about
so
the cage.
It's so
90s. Yep. Oh, remember the voicemail I played to you when they locked up Nicole in the cage?
Oh, yeah.
Girl.
That Xander.
Girl.
Yeah.
Oh.
Flashbacks.
Yeah, lots of flashbacks. Okay, and was that it? Is that the week?
I think that was it.
All right, well, that has been your week of Days, and it's now time for our segments. And we'll start with mine, which is Tony's official 3 Snaps Award. Thank you. All right, so my official 3 Snaps Award goes to Lani and Valerie for Shade Fest 2018. Because I don't know the exact lines, mm-hmm. but this is what I heard in that conversation.
Okay.
Was like, oh, hey girl, when is your due date? Oh, you know, it's in August. Are you sure? Because I'm thinking like it's more September. No, bitch, it is in August. What are you talking about? No, I think it's in September. Are you sure? It's very that.
It was that. Just with, you know.
And then it was kind of ending with Lani being like, bitch, get out of my business.
Because, you know, she had her dad right there and, you know, Valerie's right here. So she's like, ha, happy with dad. And then she's over here and she's like,
It's like,
yeah.
Just calm down, you know. Yeah.
You gotta have the eyes like,
And then he's, and then, you know, Abe, my dad, is not picking up on anything.
On nothing. No. He's just happy.
He brought the rest. He's excited, you know.
So that's who my three snaps were goes to Sal and Vanessa for Shadefest 2018. Thank you. And that, oh, wait. Oh, we already got calls coming in. And now it's time for
Mark's Quote of the Week.
There it is. All right. So mine happened right at the beginning of the week. So that always makes me very happy.
Mm-hmm. One and done.
Because as the week goes along, I'm like, oh, shit. I'm going to have to dig. Yeah. So thank you to Galen Gehring for walking into the police station. When Hattie and Anna and everybody, the gaggle of craziness was going on.
Yes.
And he was in the other room and he walked in. It's not even that funny, but I laughed so hard. He's like, everyone's in one piece. That's a good sign. And I literally laughed out loud. I was like, thank you. Quote of the week.
Quote of the week. And
done. Check.
Quote of the week.
Thank you.
And now it's time for Fan of the Week. I like the music one.
Fan of the Week.
that must be new.
Some of us.
Wait a minute. That took me by surprise. I was not expecting that.
See, we made to do it again.
Yeah, yes. And now it's time for
Dishin Days Fan of the Week.
Wow.
That was me. Swear to God, at 3 a.m. I could not sleep. I woke up and I was like on my computer. I was like, you know, I keep saying I'm going to do a Fan of the Week thing. I want to work on that. So that was me at 3 a.m. doing a little thing.
Your best work.
Thank you so much.
Today.
Thank you. So Fan of the Week this week is going to go to, I saw this on Twitter when I was actually coming in today. It's a Twitter account called Team Elani, which I thought was appropriate. It's the Twitter handle is Eli and Lani. It's Twitter, the at Eli and Lani. It's run by K186. And I don't know if this is a word. I'm just going to spell. I don't know if it's supposed to say something because it doesn't say anything to me. A-R-I-E-T-A-L-P. Is the other person who runs it. Those are their Twitter handles.
Okay.
So I thought it was appropriate, since of our guests today,
that
they get Fan of the Week.
Yeah, yay. The girl who runs it, they're really sweet.
Yeah.
They're very sweet.
Yeah, so that's it. Fan of the Week. Take care. It's a duel. It's a co, because they were both running together. K and Eritalp.
Good job. Nice.
Well, that has been...
Do that again.
One more time, Steven.
Dishin Days Fan of the Week.
That woohoo is what's getting it. That's what
I just heard the woohoo this time.
Woohoo! You'll get something new each time. Each time there'll be something new.
I love it. All right, so we're gonna open the phone lines.
I need to sleep through the night. This is what we've learned.
Yeah. So please call in. I have already forgotten the number.
Uh-oh. It's not, we do not see anything.
It's not up on the screen. 424-253-0749. All right. So you guys call in. You can talk to us live. We're all here. And if you have any questions, feel free to call in. Perfect. Hello, caller. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV's Dishin Days. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Brittany.
Hey, Brittany.
Hi, Brittany.
Hey, Brittany.
Where are you?
Good. How are you guys?
We're good. Doing good. Do you have a question or comment?
What I was thinking was, it's just for Eli and Lani.
They're both here.
Uh-huh.
Hi.
Yeah. Hi. My question was, what's gonna happen now that Eli knows?
Mm-mm. Oh, now they can't reveal secrets because we're all trying to keep our jobs.
Without giving away too much.
Yeah.
I mean, well, you're definitely gonna have to stay tuned, but I think
you know, they have to try to figure out what their next move is. You know, Lani made it very clear that she wants Eli to keep this between them two and allow JJ to be the father. So I think we have to see if that's what Eli wants.
Is
the, right. Or the ball, if he's going to allow that. Yeah.
Ball is in your court, Eli. You going to do? You going to go for the three or go for the layup? I can't believe that I was able to talk basketball.
I'm impressed. Wow.
I don't know nothing about basketball either. And I was up. So the three is giving the baby is a layup, giving it away.
Well, thank you, Brittany, for calling in.
Thank you, Brittany.
Thank you.
Bye.
And that Twitter handle is Ariat Alp.
Yes, Ariat, yeah.
Ariat is her name. So sorry,
shout out to Ariat.
Completely butchered that.
Oh. And I messaged with her, so I should know. Yes.
Yeah.
I just
Ariat Alp. And K are the two that run out.
While we're waiting for phone calls, I forgot to mention at the top of the show, happy 3-year anniversary.
Yeah.
Edition Day.
Happy anniversary.
Officially been doing this for 3 years.
I should get an award.
How about me? Hello, caller. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV's Dishin Days. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Mike Riley from New York.
Hey. Oh, Mike Riley. Oh, are y'all familiar with Mike Riley too?
I think so.
Okay. Riley's a favorite.
I was just happy to hear homie.
Favorite of who?
Everyone.
Mark. We don't need four hosts now. You can go. Oh.
Shayfest 2018.
Uh-huh. Shayfest.
Mike Riley, what do you want?
Okay. Well, hello, everyone.
First Hi.
Of all,
it must be so hard having such, you know, terrible looking guests on the
show. Right?
Thank you for saying that.
These two people are. It's crazy.
I mean, they are right.
No, truthfully, I am an advocate of having Lani and Eli be a couple. I think you guys look great together. I think your chemistry is terrific. You work really well together. And
thank you.
I'm just hoping that happens. But I do have one little question for Sal.
Yes. Hi.
I feel that Lani had an easy out when it came to Valerie, because truthfully, Valerie... I mean, we're all making a joke about it, but that was a HIPAA violation. So Lani easily could have said, look, you want to keep your medical license, you're going to keep my secret.
Right.
Why didn't you go that route?
Right, but I hear that, and of course, I probably would have done that in my real life, but right. she is the woman that her father loves. Yeah. And I think that that's also in the back of her head, too. You know, she doesn't want to drag her father into this, and you know, this is something that Lani needs to figure out for herself, you know, and it is, you know, this is Eli's mother, so she wants to, you know, she wants to play her cards right, and she doesn't want it to get ugly. If it gets ugly, then it's all going to come out.
Yeah.
You know, so she's really trying to protect not only herself, but you know, JJ and her dad, and she's not trying to take it that way.
Right. That's the baby's grandma.
Yeah.
That's a great answer.
It's the grandma. And
very sensible.
Yeah.
And, you know, her father loves him. Loves her.
who in Salem doesn't like blackmail? I had to think about that at first, because when you said blackmail, I was like, oh, blackmail. Like that blackmail. Not like this blackmail.
M-A-I-L.
But like, yeah.
But anyway, that was really my question. You guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
That they pair you off. But even if they don't, the two of you, along with Camilla and Casey, you all have great chemistry together.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Bye, everyone.
All right, bye, Mike. Thank you, Lamon and Sal. Willa, who's our
Willa,
our longtime fan.
Yes,
she said hello.
Hi.
Tell my boo I said hi.
Yes. Hi, hello.
One thing that we forgot to mention was the great scene that you had with Susan or Julie.
Mm-hmm.
I like those tender moments that they get to have with each other, because I always felt like you connected with her like initially before everything hit the fan.
Yeah. So, well, initially when Eli first came on the scene, she was kind of the one that kind of took him under her wing, mm-hmm. and they were able to develop a relationship. So really, at the beginning, he kind of was all she, all, sorry, Susan, wait, Susan, that, what's the character's name?
Julie.
Yeah. Oh, I cannot, yeah. I cannot keep up with all these names. Mm-hmm. Last names too?
Yeah.
They better not do middles. All right, so look, so I think that, you know, Julie was really all that Eli had when he first came into Salem.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I personally, myself, I love working with Susan.
I was just going to say, it must love be such a treat.
Well, I say, yeah. Terrell Bellinger just asked, his question goes to Lamon, what is it like doing scenes with your on-screen grandparents, Bill and Susan Seaforth Hayes?
Yeah, mm-hmm. you know, it's always a fun time. You know, they're just really great to work with. They're really down to earth.
Yeah.
And, you know, them being there for as many years as they have, they don't walk in like that, you know.
Yeah.
Every time they walk in, they're fresh, they're new, they're happy to be there. Yeah. They're happy to see everyone, which you know, just it's just a great environment for everyone.
Yeah. Very beautiful.
Oh, perfect.
Oh, thank you.
Hello, caller. Welcome to AfterBuzz TV's Dishin Days. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, it's Christian.
Hello, Christian.
Hello, Christian.
That was
I had to do that. Why was I the only one that reacted to it? You did too. I was like, hello, Christian. What do you have to say to me?
Hi, how's it going?
Good. Now that you've called.
What's your question?
Yeah, my question is for Sal and Lamon.
Mm-hmm.
Have you guys filmed the episodes where the secret, the baby secret came out?
Where the what?
Where the secrets come out.
I love the way he said secret.
Yeah, I know, right?
Wait, have we filmed it?
It's actually my favorite episode.
Yeah. Have you filmed
it? It's actually my favorite storyline, so.
The one, what just came out on Friday? Is that what you're asking?
No, he's asking, has you filmed the scene where the secret of Eli being the father has come out to everybody?
To everyone.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Have we filmed it?
Yeah, I don't know if you can say that. Can you?
How many months would you be?
Yeah, that's what I asked. That was actually.
I cannot answer that actually because that job. Yes, I'm sorry. Yeah. I cannot answer that.
Things are coming.
You just have to, since you love the story, you have to just stick.
It may not have come out yet.
Yeah, we'll walk into work Monday and our dressing rooms will
empty.
Be clear.
Right. I'm sorry, I can't answer that. Just keep watching.
And
I
keep calling in and talking to us.
Yeah.
Love it.
But Eli knows.
All right.
Christian, before you hang up, where are you from?
I was just wanting to get some, you know,
inside.
Inside school.
We know what you're after.
Everybody wants inside.
Or something. But my prediction for this storyline was, like, I think the story will come out, like, in the summer or something.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Christian, where are you from?
Everything.
Christian, where are you from?
Yeah. Oh, from France.
I knew it. I knew it!
Calm down, lady. You're married. Thank you, Christian,
you
for calling
accent,
in.
Right?
Yeah.
Wait, Christian.
Ciao.
Thank you, Christian.
Au revoir.
Christian.
Au revoir.
Mon ami.
Au revoir. Oh, yeah. It's ciao, Italian.
Yeah,
darn
maybe.
It.
Ciao.
It's all right.
They say it in German, too.
Okay.
They say it in German, too. Ciao, ciao.
Just sound fancy.
Terrell in our chat room wants to know, Sal, if you still keep in touch with Kyler.
I do. Yes, I do. I absolutely adore Kyler. Mm-hmm. He is...
Is that your code name, Terrell?
What?
He wants to know if you still keep in touch with Tyler.
No.
Terrell.
First of all, if you look in the chat room, it says Terrell Bellinger. My question goes to Sal. Do you keep in touch
with
Barbara Osprey?
He has another account with Terrell, and he sits there.
Didn't even change the first letter of the name. Nothing.
You give a boy a compliment one time, and all of a sudden, you're just paired with him forever. Y'all will never let me down.
My cheeks really
will never let me live that down.
Hilarious.
No, Terrell.
Terrell, do you have something else to say?
Okay, Terrell, the real Terrell. Yes, I do. I love Kyler, and I hope to stay in his life forever. He is like my little brother.
Yeah.
I think because we started at the same time, and we had to create a relationship on set, and then we had to have it personally to kind of have that brother sister feel. But yeah, I do. I love that kid.
Does
he boil your potato?
Wait, what?
Not my little brother.
No.
Days, boiling potatoes?
No, Days J said, Kyler boils Tony's potato.
Oh. Somebody was from a long time ago. Somebody said that a long time ago. Somebody's boiled someone's potato or something. So I just remember it from that. That's hysterical.
You give a guy a compliment one time.
Eli, does Lonnie boil your potato? I mean, I don't know.
And last question before we have to wrap up. Taylor Jones wants to know, for Sal and Lamon, who is your current favorite Days character that is not your own?
Mm. Abigail. Yeah. I love me some Marcy Miller, and I love what she's doing with Abigail.
I would probably say Abigail, and I love Rafe.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
I do too.
I love those Rafe. Are two good ones. All right. Well, that's all we have. Currently, that's it.
Fun.
That's the end of our show.
Really
it goes by so quick.
I know. Yeah. It's like, it's already done.
I know. It's already done. Well, thank you guys for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Of course.
Thank you for having us.
You guys are more than welcome to come back anytime.
Oh, you guys are actually going to call me back?
Yes. Of course.
I've been thinking about, 2.5, almost 3 years to get here.
Listen, if you're driving by the studio and you're like, I'm just going to pop in, you know, we're here every Sunday at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 7 p.m. Eastern. Standard time. You like that plug, baby. Uh-huh. All right, but before we head out, Mark J. Freeman, let the folks know where they can stalk you on Twitter.
Can stalk me on Twitter at Lorraine Love, LorraineLove.
Or in all your social
media. Same on Instagram, yeah.
Okay, and Tami?
And you can follow me on Twitter at Tami Goveia, Instagram Tami_Goveia.
And Michael?
You can find me on Instagram, MLMattis1, or on Twitter, MLMattis1, and on Instagram, MLMattis.
And yes. In case they don't know already, Sal, where can they find you on social media?
I am on all social media. You can find me at Sal Stowers on Instagram and Twitter and all that good stuff.
Yeah. Lamon.
I
still say Lamon. I still get
Lamon.
Better than layman. Lamon Archey. At Lamon Archey on Twitter and Instagram.
I remember when I interviewed you the first time on the red carpet at the Daytime Emmys, you walked over and I said, I just want to make sure I'm saying it's Archey, right? And you were like, yeah, but it's Lamon. And I was like, oh, I'm glad you said that. I would have messed that up.
Good thing you asked.
And I'm glad I asked.
Yeah. And, of course, you can follow all of us on our Instagram and Facebook page, Dishin Days, or on Twitter, _DishinDays. And you can follow me on all social media platforms, at Lounging with Tony. And really quick, shout out to Bill and Susan Hayes for receiving the Lifetime Achievement at the Daytime Emmy.
So we have
that to look forward to. And, of course, you have another recap to look forward to next Sunday right here on AfterBuzz TV, where we give you a full recap of NBC's number one hit soap opera, Days of Our Lives. We'll see you next week. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only. They do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.